Very good morning, students. Now I am going to continue with the same chapter. Today I am going to start with the third experiment of J.J. Thomson. Okay, third experiment of J.J. Thomson. So what he did? So in the third experiment, what he did? He applied an electric field inside the discharge tube. Okay, this one is cathode, this one is anode. So he applied an electric field inside the discharge tube. So what he observed, after applying an electric field in the path of the cathode rays, so these are the cathode rays, he applied an electric field. Okay, he applied an electric field in the path of the cathode rays. So he observed that the cathode rays got deflected towards the positively charged plate. He observed that cathode rays were deflected towards the positively charged plate. See, this one is the negatively charged plate and this one is positively charged plate. So why these rays were not deflected towards the negatively charged plate? Because opposite signs attracted each other. So we know that these cathode rays were made up of negatively charged particle. So obviously it will be deflected towards the positively charged particles. Okay, so he observed that the cathode rays got deflected towards the positively charged plate. It did not deflect towards the negatively charged plate, since these rays are made up of negative charged particles. So from this he concluded that cathode rays are made up of negatively charged particle. With the help of this experiment, he proved that cathode rays are made up of negatively charged particles. Negatively charged particles, and it is called electrons. So in the first experiment, he proved that cathode rays travel in a straight line and it cast a shadow, okay, of the object placed in the path of the cathode rays. In the second experiment, he proved that cathode rays consist of a stream of fast moving particles. With the help of that fast moving particles, only the light paddle wheel start rotating. And in the third experiment, he proved that cathode rays were made up of negatively charged particles. That is why it got deflected towards the positively charged plate. So these cathode rays are made up of negatively charged particles and they are called electrons. Okay, now the properties of electrons. The properties of electrons. So first one is, the electron have a definite mass. Electron have a definite mass. Okay, and definite electric charge. Definite electric charge. Electric charge. So what is the electric charge? Negative. Okay, because we proved that electrons are made up of negatively charged particles, so electron is having negative charge on it. Okay, second one, the nature of the electron is independent. Okay, the nature of the electron is independent of the nature of the gas used in the discharge tube and the material of the cathode. Okay, suppose if you change the material of this plate. Okay, I explained you earlier only that this plates are made up of any material. If you change the material of this plate, then also the properties and the constituent of the electrons will not change. I told you that inside the discharge tube one gas is filled. If you change the gas, then also the properties and the constituent will not change. Electrons properties and the constituent will not change. It means that the electrons, the nature of the electron is totally independent of the nature of the gas and the material of the cathode plate. Okay, now third one is, electron have a negligible mass. The mass of the electron is very, very, very less. It is very light particles. Okay, electron's mass is negligible. Okay, mass is negligible. That is 9.1 into 10 raised to the power minus 28 gram, or about 1 upon 1837 of the mass of the hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen we know that hydrogen is the lightest among all the atoms. So the mass of the electron is very negligible, you can say. You can say it is zero. Okay, now next one is, electrons carries 1.602 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 coulomb of negative charge. Okay, now fourth property, electrons are denoted by like this. Okay, here this zero is indicating mass and this one is indicating negative charge. Okay, one unit negative charge. Okay, and we know that electrons are made up of negatively charged particles, that is why the charge is negative. So these are the properties of electrons. Now I am going to explain you the discovery of protons. Okay, discovery of protons. So it is proved that all atoms contain electrons. Means negative charge is present in the atoms. Okay, now since an atom is electrically neutral, I explained to you earlier, since an atom is electrically neutral, there should be a positive charge also. Okay, then only it is possible that it can be neutralized. Okay, so since an atom is electrically neutral, there has to be positively charged particles present in the atom to neutralize the negative charge. Okay, to neutralize this negative charge, positive charge should also present in the atoms. So in 1886, a German scientist, Eugen Goldstein. Okay, Eugen Goldstein proved the existence of the positively charged particle in an atom, and it is only known as proton. So what he did, he also took one discharge tube. Okay, this discharge tube is also called the Crookes discharge tube, because this discharge tube was designed by William Crookes. Okay, William Crookes. That is why this discharge tube is also called Crookes discharge tube, because it was designed by William Crookes. Okay, so what he did, he also took one discharge tube. Okay, Goldstein performed an experiment by using a discharge tube, okay, containing a perforated cathode. Okay, perforated cathode means in the cathode plate he made some holes. Okay, suppose this one is a cathode plate, he made some holes in it so that anode rays can pass through it. Okay, in the experiment of electron, it was not perforated, but in the time of the discovery of the proton, Goldstein took the cathode plate which was perforated. Okay, it had many holes. Okay, that is why it is also called canal rays also. Okay, so this you will study in the higher classes. So he took one discharge tube and he fixed one cathode perforated plate, and this side he fixed an anode plate. Okay, same thing. Okay, negative charge. So that is why it is cathode plate, and this side is connected with the positive side. So this is called anode plate. Okay, same thing he did. He took one vacuum tube to make the pressure of the air or the gases at a very low temperature. Okay, this one is the high voltage generator. Okay, for passing electric current. So what he observed, when he a high voltage of electric current was passed through this cathode, when a very high voltage current is passed, okay, through this cathode, so he saw that a faint red color glow was observed by him. Okay, it means that the rays was coming from this side. Okay, now this time the rays was coming from the anode side. Okay, from the positive side. Okay, so this showed that some rays were produced from the anode side and it is moving towards the cathode side. Okay, so he showed that some rays were produced from the anode and move from the anode to the cathode. That is why it causes a glow. Okay, behind the cathode, because the rays were coming from this side, that is why the glow was formed, the glow was observed behind the cathode. Okay, and because it was perforated cathode, so that is why the anode rays was passing through it, and it cast a glow of red color was observed, okay, behind the cathode. Now you understand, since these rays were coming from the positive side, so that is why these rays are made up of the positively charged particles, and they are called anode rays. Okay, they are only called anode rays, and it containing protons. Okay, they are only called anode rays, and in this rays the particles, the positive particles are present, they are only called proton. So I hope you understood. Okay, what this Goldstein did, he took one discharge tube, fixed one perforated cathode plate, okay, and he passed high voltage current. When he passed high voltage current, he observed that some rays were coming from the anode side, okay, and he saw that one faint red glow, okay, was formed behind the perforated cathode plate. So this proved that the rays, since the rays were coming from the positive side, so these rays were made up of positively charged particles. So that is why these rays are called anode rays, and the particles which are present in these anode rays, the positive particles, they are only called protons. So proton was discovered by Goldstein, okay, and electron was discovered by J.J. Thomson. Okay, now the properties of the protons. What are the properties of the protons? First one, protons have the same mass as that of hydrogen atom. Okay, hydrogen atom's mass and the mass of the proton is same. Okay, that is 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 24 gram. Okay, this is the mass of the proton. It means the mass of the proton is 1837 times of the electron. Okay, I told you the mass of an electron is very less, it is negligible. Okay, now second one is, a proton has an equal and opposite charge as that of an electron. So the proton electric charge will be same, okay, equal to the electron, 1.602 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 coulomb. Okay, the charge of the electron and the charge of the proton is equal in an atom. Okay, remember it. Okay, so a proton has an equal and opposite charge as that of electron. So the charge will be equal. Okay, now the third one is, proton is denoted by P1, okay, plus 1. Okay, where 1 is the unit positive charge and 1 atomic mass unit is the mass. Okay, this one is the mass, okay, and this one is the 1 unit positive charge. Electron was denoted by minus 1 and here 0. 0 is the mass, okay, this one is the negative charge, and proton 1 is the mass, okay, mass, and plus 1, it is the positive unit charge, okay, 1 unit positive charge. So these are the properties of protons. So in my next video I will explain you the discovery of neutrons. Thank you so much.